everyone, and welcome to Cam Girl Diaries podcast. My name is Luscious Leisha. Today we have Daya Fallon with us. Hey, Daya, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, thanks. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
So I have a YouTube channel called Daya Fallon. Mm-hmm. I am currently a cam model, but I've been in the sex industry for 15 years. I started off as a stripper. And I've been camming now for 11 months.
How do you like it? How do you like the camming thing?
I have good and bad days, to be honest. I loved it when I first started. And now that I've been in it for not as long as I danced, I have my good and my bad days for sure.
Do you think mental health has a lot to do with it? Because I have issues with mine, with camming.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. I don't know if it's because of mental health or if it's because of the industry or the line of work.
Yeah.
Or my perspective on things.
Yeah, I think that all like meshes together. I know like some days I'll be like really in a bad mood and I'll try to go on Chatterbait. I'm like, why would I do this? I'm just gonna be mean to everybody, you know?
Do you do that?
Yeah, it's bad. Like I get really, really pissed off for no reason.
No reason?
Yeah. Yeah. If I get depressed and stuff, I shouldn't go on. You know, I don't think I should.
I agree. Yeah. I try.
Yes. Me too.
And, but I do overall prefer it over other jobs.
Yeah. It's nice you get to stay home too. You know, you don't have to go out and actually deal with actual people.
That's definitely the best part.
Yeah. So you said you were a stripper. How long did you do that for?
14 and a half ish, almost 15 years.
Wow. Did you like it? Obviously you probably did.
I feel almost ashamed. Not really. I loved it.
That's okay. Good.
Were you a dancer?
No.
No,
I wish I was. I don't have the body for that shit.
Oh, I think that anybody can do it.
That's mm-hmm. cool. I always just kind of think of just like, you know, you got to be super skinny and I guess not.
I'm not skinny.
You're hot though. Definitely hot.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That was something that an insecurity of mine because I worked at like white upscale clubs and I was like the big girl.
Right.
You know, there.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy. That's hard to believe. So I think you look really hot. I wouldn't consider you overweight or anything like that. You look really good.
I'm like 170 pounds.
Dude, no way.
And I'm wow. 170 pounds.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
I was definitely one of the bigger girls, and it was something that was always like commented on. But I think that anybody could do it. I worked at other clubs where all sizes were welcomed, but for some reason I was able to like weasel myself into other clubs where like I don't know if it's the way I talk or my face that I like made the cut. But I was
like, you're beautiful, girl. You're beautiful. You're not big
Thank
at all,
you.
Dude. Not at all.
So I watched, there's a lot of episodes on this Cam Girl Diaries thing. And I tried to like watch a couple before we got on here. How long have you been camming for?
I have been camming for a little bit over 2 years.
Okay.
Yeah. This is my first like stint in the adult industry.
Oh.
Yeah. I mean, I've always been like super sexual and like sold nudes like way before I knew it was like a thing, you know?
Really? But,
yeah. Have you always been like super sexual too? Like always into like that kind of stuff?
I was hypersexual. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Like just very comfortable with being like naked in my sexuality.
Me too. I can talk about, I'm like that too. I can talk about anything and everything. People are like, you just said that? I'm like, yeah, I said that.
Do you find that people are super open with you too because you're open as yes. well?
Yeah, it's a good bring that out in people. I noticed. Are you like that too?
Yeah. Talking again about my insecurities, like when I'm navigating mm-hmm. through like what people call civvies.
Yes.
I'm like always like nervous to make friends, and then because I don't like to lie to people. So
I'm the same as you. Exactly the same.
A minute before I tell them that I'm a sex worker, and I've had nothing but good experiences. You know.
Good. That's fucking awesome.
Yeah. And then I end up hearing about.
Yeah, I've heard some crazy shit. you know, when you tell people, because I'm super honest, I always tell people, like, my family knows to an extent and stuff. And I told one of my family members, and he's like all against it. He's like, you really do that? I'm like, yeah, what's wrong with that? He's like, that's gross. I'm like, nah, that's your opinion, I guess, you know. But that's the only like bad experience. But I've heard some horrible shit. And I feel bad for some girls that have to deal with that. So
yeah, you were talking about like your family, like not like only one person knows, like they know, but they don't know.
My whole family knows what I do. Mm-hmm. To an extent. One of my family members though, he doesn't agree with it. You know, he's with shit talk and everything, but people don't, I mean, they just look at it from the outside.
Yeah.
They don't see everything, you know, they can't really judge. I don't judge anybody. So I don't think people should. It's not very nice at all.
Yeah. I try not to, but I sometimes have my moments.
That's human nature though. We slip up once in a while, you know? So you're on Chatterbait?
I'm not, I'm actually on MFC.
Oh, you are? Mm-hmm. I thought you were on Chatterbait for some reason. Cool. Do you like it there?
I do. I do a lot. I tried Chatterbait. you giggled.
I'm on there.
I had an account that kind of just sat for a while. And then when I went on, there was no traffic coming in my room. Mm-hmm. Like zero. And you know how you can pay on Chatterbait to have people come in the room?
Yes.
I did that and it didn't bring anybody in my room. So I've heard very good things about Chatterbait. And I know they're super, super popular.
They are, but lately it's been a shit show over there.
Okay.
Something's wrong with like everything because there's nobody on there right now. Like I generally have a lot of people in my room. I've had nothing but good luck on there. You know, mm-hmm. It's just, I like mm-hmm. tokens. I like that token sound, you know, when they vibe with lovin's and shit. I like that. But yeah, it's really slow. Everybody's experiencing it right now. I don't really know what's going on. No one really knows. So
yeah. MFC is actually not busy for me personally.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to use the word lucky, but maybe lucky.
Yes.
I also do you do Skype shows?
I do. Yeah. Do? I see them all the time. Mm-hmm. Do you use it a lot?
I use it like I collect a lot more money on Venmo and Cash App than I do with actual tokens.
Same.
I know it's frowned upon.
It is, but it's okay. We all do it. I do it a lot. You make a lot more money that way. A ton.
Most of my money is Cash App and Venmo.
Me too. Me too. Did you, I want to ask you, you file business taxes, obviously, because you're self-employed. When you file, did you file your Cash App and like PayPal stuff as income? Because I found out that you didn't have to. I didn't. Because that's where all my shit is.
No.
I did a lot of research. Okay. I didn't either. So I just seen if you knew anything.
I honestly want to. So when I started camming was October of last year. And I didn't actually start receiving, start taking Cash App and Venmo. I was so new that I didn't know if people could. I heard horror stories that people would do like try to do refunds or stuff like that with Cash App and Venmo. So I didn't take that until after October. No, it wasn't October. I started in, yeah, actually late October. So I did October, November, December, and I did nothing but tokens. So by the time the tax season had, you know, like gone into, like I had already started collecting cash and Venmo past that. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it totally does. I hate tokens. You really don't make any money that way. You really don't.
You can.
It's hard as fuck.
You can, but it's and it's weird because when I wasn't collecting Cash App and tokens, Cash App and Venmo, I was making okay on tokens. I mean, everybody's definition of good is very different.
It is. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. So I was brand new and my cut was like $2,500 a week. And I was,
damn, that's really good, girl.
Yeah. But I was so excited when I first started camming that I was,
me too.
Yeah.
And now I'm like, you know, down there.
Yeah.
It's really fun when you first start, like, especially that first week, because you have that first week, whatever site you're on, they like promote your ass, you know, it's great. And then it's like, okay, where's everybody?
So the site that I'm on right now, MFC, only does 10 hours of new girl.
Really?
They started that after the new year.
I don't know how I feel about that because sometimes a week seems a little long to me. Yeah. I guess what Chatterbait does is a week. It does seem long.
It's
because then it really puts us like at the back end of the pages there because there's a lot of people that join every day, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think I like the 10 hours better. It sounds better.
Are you on several sites?
Yeah, I'm on Chatterbait like primarily, and then I'm on an MFC. I like it over there. I like the interface. It's totally better than Chatterbait. I went over the first time and I was like, what is all this goodness? Like, we don't get to decorate on Chatterbait. You don't get to do your chat room any cool colors, or we don't have any options like that. Nothing. There's nothing. See, I like it. And a lot of people follow me over there and they like it too, but they're like, whoa, what is this? You know, because it's Chatterbait's totally different. Totally.
Yeah, I don't know why I do want to have several platforms that I can kind of like jump in and out of for when I'm on one and it's slow. Because I have had, you know, the stream where you're not making shit. I didn't
Yes.
have nowhere else to go, you know?
Yeah, you definitely should. I heard a lot of models are doing that Stream 8. I started on Stream 8 way back in the day, but it's just private. That to me is really boring. You know, you're just waiting for somebody to take you private. And I was on Sky Private, same thing there. I can't do it. My attention span is not there for that.
Where
Sky Private?
I haven't heard of that one.
That one actually just uses Skype, but they're taking a cut of what you're making. So I'm thinking in my head, like, I should just do this myself.
Yeah,
And I was dead.
I did hear about that one, and it was watching Cam Girl Diaries. A little blonde girl. I'm sorry, I forgot.
Yeah, I don't remember her name either, but I remember that
It
episode.
was her.
Yeah.
She was talking about how well she does on there.
Yeah, I didn't do good at all on there. Like, I was just, I can't sit there and just like, like wait around. I can't. That's just me. ADHD brain, so.
It's just see, I was feeling guilty like today, because I'm like, fuck, you know, like sometimes I'm like, you know, an hour or two will go by and I'm not making shit, you know, not shit. And
Right.
then I'm thinking about people in, that are in other professions, and they make a lot less, you know.
A lot less. Yeah.
And
I know. I know how you feel about that. I feel that way too, and I do feel bad because I feel like I'm being greedy.
or entitled and all that.
Yeah.
And how do you feel about that?
Same
Do you
way.
think you're being entitled or greedy, or do you think
I don't.
good for you?
I don't think I am. I don't think I am. I try to give, you know, I think everybody's equal in the world. No one's better than anyone else. And when I'm sitting there, I do the same thing. I'm like, God damn it. I'm like, this sucks. Like, I'm not making anything. And I'm thinking, I do that too. I think, like, wow, if I was still working a, you know, a corporate job, I wouldn't be making anything like this. Nothing, you know?
Yeah. I totally agree with the whole like everybody's equal and stuff like that. But I'm gonna throw you a curveball. Can we not pretend that we're not pushing our putting our asses and our vaginas like literally on the internet? So I feel it doesn't matter if other people don't think that I'm worth this kind of money or not, but I feel for the work that I'm doing, which is interactive porn, that
Yeah.
we should be paid very generously.
I totally agree with you there. Yes. This profession definitely needs a pay increase, like big time, because we're putting all of our shit out there, you know?
I've gotten shit before. People are like, you're entitled, like you think you're this, you think you're that. And I'm not like a popular internet person. I don't have like hundreds of thousands of
Neither.
followers on Instagram. Like I don't have like even on my YouTube channel, but I don't think that I need that validation to feel like this industry that I'm working in, the people on the other end should know that this is a luxury, not a
Yes.
necessity.
Agree. 100%.
Yeah. And
I don't, yeah, I don't think you're entitled at all. I think that we have the right to feel that way.
yeah.
Definitely.
I mean, like,
Yeah, because this job is like, yeah, they come in and, you know, you get those douchebags that just want to tip one token every like 2 seconds. It's like, come on, man, that's 5 cents. Like, are you serious right now? And you want me to show my tits for that? No. I agree.
I had this conversation with a girlfriend that's not a sex worker, and I'm not being shady by saying it. I kind of told her how I felt, and she was like, told she nicely told me that I was a little bit like out of touch with reality, and I was like, I'm not baking cookies.
Right. You're not doing Miss Susie Homemaker over here. Like, you're doing some risque shit. Like, that's what we do, you know? And people should pay more for that. They should.
I feel like
Agreed.
have you searched yourself online? And
Oh, yeah.
your stuff is stolen and on other sites.
Everywhere. Yes.
And other sites are making money off of you, and it's like,
Yeah. And nobody will take them down because most of them are international.
yes.
You know, they can't do shit about it. It's bullshit.
Yeah.
Here's my cut. You know, that's me. That is me. You know, it's bullshit.
Yeah. You don't need a million followers to feel entitled to making
No.
your money. Like,
No, exactly. And I would definitely never think that about you. Like, I would never, like, even talking to you. Like, I watched your YouTube channel, which is awesome, by the way. I really like it.
Thank
I really
you.
like it. And you're definitely down to earth. You're not out of touch at all.
Thanks.
You know what's up. You know, you definitely do.
Thank you. Sometimes I question myself. I'm like,
Yeah.
I'm like,
I like that too. I'm like, should I not feel this way?
yeah.
Or should I? Yeah, people make you think twice about things sometimes. You're like, damn. But our job is not like for the normal, everyday, average person.
I agree.
Most people can't handle this shit.
Huh? Yeah, no,
So most people can't handle this kind of shit. Even like the feedback from the guys. Like some of the guys are pure assholes, you know? I just want to grab them through the screen some days, you know? You imagine dealing with that, like working in an office. Like they couldn't even deal with that shit. Like some of the shit these people say is bad. It's real bad.
yeah, I used to deal with that show at the strip club.
Yeah. So you're conditioned just a little bit, right? Just a tad.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm nasty bitch. I would be like, duh, 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 and I was like, okay,
Yeah.
it's time for you to go. Like, you need to pull my heels up. Like, it's
I can tell you have strong boundaries. And you've had that for a while, haven't you? Your boundaries.
yeah. You have
That's
to.
good.
If you're gonna be in
That's really good.
the sex industry, you need to
Yeah.
have them.
And I think so many girls don't. And they just pushed around, you know, and you can't. It's sad.
It is sad, and that's why some of these guys think that they can, buy you for a session for 25 or 30 bucks. And it's because like some girls are just like
Yeah, I had this issue with some stuff I was looking through for an interview, and I was talking to Gary, the producer, about it, and I said, you know, these images are not high quality. They are not done with taste. You know, this is what, you know, the background's all fucked up. Like she's just all weird in the picture. Like if she's selling those pictures, then they should be top notch. Like when you, what you sell is, you know, it's representative of you and the industry you're in. And like those kind of people that don't give a shit about what they're putting out gives us a bad name. And
Yeah.
it goes along with the girls that are like, oh yeah, I'll do show my titties for like a dollar. No, that's not how it goes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Ugh.
It's so stressful some days. It really
I
is.
wish that everybody in the industry would just kind of like step it up a notch, because then collectively, as a community, we would all do better.
Agreed. And the stigma, if that wasn't there, we would all do way better.
The stigma, like you just, what would you think is a stigma?
I don't think it's ever gonna go away. Like how, I don't know, like women shouldn't be doing this kind of work. You know, we shouldn't be doing this kind of stuff. It's not a job. It's not, you know, it is a fucking job, first and foremost, you know. Nobody recognizes us as doing a like a job. To me, this is.
Yeah.
How do you react to people that ask you, like, why do you do this? Have anybody ask you
Not anymore.
that? You're way past that, right? What were you gonna say?
I was going to ask you the same question.
How do I react? I say, well, I got into this for, I didn't willingly get into this. Like it was survival for me. So there was no other option. And once, and I've always been like this anyway, like super like sexual about everything in my life. So it just came naturally, you know?
Wow. Okay.
It is what it is. If you don't like me for that, then there's a door. You know, that's just me.
Yeah. So you say you got into it for survival?
Yes. Yeah.
I started, obviously, I said I was been doing it for 15 years. So I started when I was 18. And I started, and this is because I wanted to. I knew before I turned 18 that I wanted to be like a sex worker. I glorified Playboy models because I'm like a 90s baby. I was like a
Me
girl.
too.
I didn't want to ask you
Yeah.
what you are because I don't want to be rude, but
Yeah, well, I was born in the 80s, but I love the 90s. I grew up in the 90s, so.
yeah, I was like an ugly kid. I was shy.
Was a big dork.
So I was like,
Yeah.
I just want to be like,
It was fun.
I want to be a hot
I know, I love. Did you like Madonna back in the
I did when she made out with
day? Madonna. Right, that was hot.
That's when I was like, oh, I like girls.
Yeah, exactly. So since you got into the industry like willingly, it's something you knew you wanted to do. Did you want to ask you, did you know like about safety?
With online work or like at the strip club?
Well, kind of, yeah, both. Did you like, well, when you went in there, did you know like you needed to protect yourself maybe from some guys if something went down?
naturally, yes. As shy and dorky and introverted as I was, I kind of a bitch at the same time. And so like protecting myself is natural to me. And also the first time I ever worked at a strip club, there was a veteran, I guess, that just came up to me. Mm-hmm. Hey, I know it's your first day, like you're super young. And she was like, I need you not to trust anybody. And for some reason that really like stuck in my head. Yeah, yeah, but you're gonna go through shit in the sex industry.
Yeah, it's a given. You know, you're definitely going to. See, I have this thing where I get upset with like when people, you know, don't understand. I've talked to younger people like Cam, and they don't understand that person talking to you behind the screen may not be that person. Mm. They don't understand it, and that really pisses me off.
Yeah,
because I just don't understand how you just trust the screen name. I don't get that. I'm 20 years old, blah, 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 and you really believe that? I don't believe anybody.
I've heard bad stories since I started camming.
Oh, yeah.
I've heard bad stories from, like, guys telling me, like, oh, I met a cam model that was, like, in a bad situation, and I flew her out here, and I took her to a motel room, and, like, we did this, like, they're just straight up telling me, and I'm not, like, I don't know if it's fact, but for certain.
I know, it was scary.
But I believe it.
I believe it too. Everything I hear like that cam girl that got murdered when she met somebody, like, I think it was like 5 or 6 years ago. That shit scares the shit out of me. I would never meet anybody. And I hear about these girls saying, you know, he flew me out. No, what? No. It's just stupidity.
And that's all that it is. You've never met.
No.
Anybody who said, mm-hmm. I haven't either, but I will. Mm-hmm. I have a sub. Because, by the way, camming has also taught me shit. Like,
yes, a lot.
Girl, I started diving into the whole dominatrix thing with camming.
Well, tell me about it. Tell us about it. I want to know about more because I'm not into that.
So I don't know why I didn't think. Because for some reason, like, they just gravitate towards me. I don't know about you, but they're like, oh, well, you dominate me. And I was like, this feels cringe because I'd never fucking dominated a man before.
Me too, same. I was like, what?
Yeah. And then I kind of started playing with it and I was like, you know, this feels a lot more natural to me than bimbifying myself, which is something that I did a lot at strip club.
Yeah.
And I really like it, to be honest. I just recently started looking into dungeons in my city.
Really?
Yes, I took a BDSM class. And I plan on being like a professional dominatrix. It's something that camming introduced me into that. So, but yeah, we were talking about meeting people in person. My first day streaming, I met somebody. And he will watch this probably. Like, we have talked every day since I streamed last year. And he will be flying out here in a couple of months to meet me, and everything's being done really safely, though. I feel like I know him. I don't mean to sound like ignorant. My man's gonna be there and everything. Like,
there you go. You got it all covered. That's what you should do. What you're doing is what everybody should do.
Yeah.
I know bitches be flying out to meet people by themselves. That's nuts to me. Are you scared though to meet somebody a little bit? No, you'll be fine.
I feel like I will use my intuition. I feel like as soon as I feel like no,
trust your gut. That's what I always say.
Yeah.
So when is this going down? Next year, you said, or a few months?
The beginning of next year. My household is very into wrestling, and the sub is also very into wrestling. There's a huge event that's happening here in Florida with wrestling. And when I was a stripper, the wrestlers were actually my customers too. So
nice.
I won't obviously say who. It'll be a thing. We're literally gonna go watch a wrestling show, and he's like flying across the country.
That's crazy. I hope everything goes well for you. It seems like it's an okay, you know, thing. It's not just you. I'd be worried if it was just you, but
it would never just be.
No, so you're smart, and that's what I wish most of these younger ones that cam would be smarter than they are, because you know they just go meet people by themselves with no protection, nothing.
I'm glad. I don't know. I don't know what people are thinking sometimes, but also like, I was younger probably. And I'm kind of glad that I got into like this when I was like older and
yeah,
savvier. Cause when I was younger,
Yeah, same with me. Like everyone says I'm 40, but everyone says like, you know, I got into the industry. Yeah, I was 38. No, I must have some good genes, but thank you. Everyone says that. Yeah, so I mean, everyone says, oh my God, you know, you're too old to do this. Like people are saying you should retire by the age 26. I'm like, retire? Are you fucking kidding me right now? I know, exactly. A big fuck you to that. I love you.
How do you feel about that? Fuck you. I'm such a feminist.
Me too. Me too. We don't go stale. Some of us get into our prime in our older ages, you know? It's different for everybody.
Yes.
I don't know. I just kind of just say like, when people say that to me, I'm just like, what? Like, you really just said that. Like, why did you have to say that? Like, what made you say that? Like, who cares? To each their own. There's grandmas on here.
I know.
You know, on Chatterbait and MFC, and they're doing porn like they're handling their business, man. To each their own. I know I had a guy ask me to, I'm on sexyjobs.com. Have you heard of that website? You can get jobs on there. Like you get porn roles and like all different kinds of shit. It's a good resource, but I'm always like trying to get porn jobs. And I'm like, then I get too scared to go. But this one guy had to speak at a dungeons. He had a dungeon only 3 hours from me. So he's like, here's my Pornhub link, you know, check it out, see what's on here. And so I'm looking and it's straight gilfs and like a couple of like milfs. But those gilfs, they're pretty intense.
Damn. So you're thinking about getting porn.
I'm too much of a wuss. I really am.
Me too.
Because I have two kids. So I don't want to not come back, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought about porn as well. Mm-hmm. I thought about
it's good money. It's really good money.
Is it?
Yeah, I mean, this guy was charging way low. He told me like $800 for a couple. I'm like, it's a little low. I've heard it's anywhere from like 4,000 up. And I was like, dude, you're like way too low. But the dungeon thing just rang in my mind because I know you're saying about the dungeon thing. Yeah. So yeah, you meet a lot of people. I've met a lot of cool people from around the world, like you have too. And they're actually really cool. They've been with me since day one.
Yeah, there are some people that on there that are, you know, they're just lonely little perverts, and that's okay. And then there's other people that really need some fucking help.
yes there is, especially the ones that say, you know, they like your skin, they really want to, you know, wear it. That's fun.
Oh girl, yeah, get fucked.
Some Buffalo Bill shit or something, like Silence of the Lambs.
Have you had any stalkers?
Yeah I actually had a guy find me on Skype, and this was when I first started, and I did not have it anywhere where anybody could find my shit. And he like hacked my IP because Chatterbait, which I have a big issue with, I talked about before, they don't let us have VPNs. Chatterbait will not let you have a VPN. Yeah. I got into an argument with support about it because I said, what? Like the site will not work for you if you have a VPN. That's what they told me. But yeah, this guy hacked and got my IP address.
And then what happened?
Well, he got into my song. I don't know about hacking or nothing like that, but he knew my full name. And, he put it on like stream a couple times, like my middle name too. And then he hacked into one of my Skype accounts and was messaging me. Nothing else. I was really scared. I put up cameras and, you know, had some protection around me at all times. But yeah, it's scary. Do you know how to hack at all? I don't know anything.
I didn't have a hack. I had somebody that was like, hey, like I'm on your personal, because I have a Facebook where it's personal. Mm-hmm. So if I don't know, only if I know you like in person, have you been on there?
Yeah.
I know you personally. I know where you work out. I know where you do this. I know where you do that. Yeah. And he added me on Snapchat. Ooh, he's probably going to fucking see this. Watch it.
Yeah, he is. Good, bitch.
When he added me on Snap, you know, do you have a Snapchat premium?
I do.
You know how sometimes when you do like the emoji faces, like their face will pop up on like an animation? Yes.
Yeah.
Girl, I'm like the FBI. Okay, so his little face popped up on there, and I Uno reversed that shit on him. And actually, he doesn't actually know that I found where he lives, who he is, but I let him know on live stream, fuck around and find out. Because
exactly.
Don't let the piggy tails and the persona online, like I just cracked my knuckles.
I heard that.
Let my man know. Like, I'm not gonna overexpose myself, but
no, but when they find out shit where you think about it, like how, like what happened to me? How the fuck did they find that? And that's scary. I don't know.
Yeah.
I know nothing about that kind of shit.
I think he was being serious. Like, even during my streams, like, he would send me videos of, like, I guess there's, like, a skit on YouTube. There is a skit on YouTube where the girl's, like, camming. I'll send you the link. You can watch it. And it's like, yeah, a kink that he had, that there's a cam girl, and he, like, breaks into her house, and he, like, murders her while she's, like, camming and shit.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm.
That's a special kind of fucked up.
I'm like, cool. I'm not gonna say too much about myself, but like, you met your match.
honestly, there are a lot of people that need a lot of help, I think.
Yeah.
A lot more than I think there is. Yeah. But yes.
That was cute till it wasn't. And
yeah.
He spent a little bit of money, so maybe he thought that I was like desperate and I would like continue to entertain it.
Mm-hmm.
And he even asked me, like, are you scared? And I was like,
oh damn.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, again, I think that goes hand in hand with like the younger, uneducated people, like doing things for cheaper and giving them information. And then they come to people like you and me and they're like, what? No. You know, we put them in their place. So yeah, that's not cool.
No, it's not. I don't think that being a sex worker or showing your tits or your ass on the internet is a freebie to want to abuse us or like harass us. Agreed. Like, no, man.
Right. So since you said you're into like feminism and women's rights, all like that kind of stuff, like I am too.
Mm-hmm.
Has anyone ever told you like porn is porn or what we do is demeaning to women? Like, how would you respond if somebody said that to you?
I agree to an extent, to be honest.
Sometimes I do too.
Mm-hmm.
How much to an extent would you say?
I think a lot of the, stuff that's like mainstream on porn is, And it men think this is fucking king, these fucking vanilla motherfuckers, is like spitting on women, hitting them, you know, like,
yeah.
And I get the BDSM stuff. Listen, I understand.
Yeah.
I get it. It can be kinky. That's hot, but that's not what you're watching. And they want to abuse women in their personal lives and put a dom filter on it. And that's not what domination is. Like, you're just a fucking asshole that doesn't like women and you want to abuse them and you want to cover it up with kink.
Mm-hmm.
However, with porn in general or camming or anything in the sex industry, I think that women should be able to do anything that they want with their bodies. And that just adult women, I have to really express that.
Yeah.
Yes. As long as it's consensual, then quite frankly, if you don't like it, it's none of your fucking business. If you don't like it, don't watch it.
Yes. Round of applause for you, because I totally agree with everything that you just said.
Yeah.
I was watching a feed on Chatterbait, and there was like 3,000 people in the room, and it's this girl getting like the shit beat out of her pretty much. And they had the filter BDSM, but you could tell she was not enjoying it at all.
That's not BDSM. That's abuse.
No, it is. And it's disgusting that many people were like getting off to that. You can't see that's wrong. I reported the room.
They know it's wrong.
I didn't say it again, but it's totally wrong. And that's disgusting. That's what people that don't know what BDSM think it is. And it's not at all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uneducated people is just like,
no, you can't cover abuse with a BDSM kink. That's not what BDSM is.
Right. And so many people try to do it. It's disgusting.
I believe in consensual.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I do feel bad when sometimes people do it out of like, desperation, and I also can empathize with that and understand, and I try not to judge. I'm a huge feminist, and I know that some feminists probably don't want me in their community, or maybe I'm like, we're not welcomed. But in my own way, I feel like I'm a huge feminist, and I'm very picky and choosy of my clients as well.
Yeah, I am too. I turn down people. Someone asked me, oh my God, I just lost my train of thought. But there was somebody that asked for something and they were going to pay a lot of money. And it really wasn't something I was okay with. I forget what it was totally, completely. And I said, no. And then the person, he's like, well, why wouldn't you? It's money. I'm like, because it goes against my morals and my standards. And a lot of people don't understand. Like, we are people just like you all are. We just work in the sex industry. But some people would say, like, say if somebody came to you and said, hey, you know, do this and that, you didn't want to do it. A lot of girls, I guess, would do it for the money. I won't. You know, I don't think you would either if you weren't comfortable with it.
Yeah, I will not sub. I will not pay. I won't play a sub role. Like, I've had shows with Skypes where people pay up front. And as soon as you drop the word bitch and whore,
I'm the same way. I had a guy come to a, he played like for something up front, it was like 1,000 tokens. Then he, you know, went to private with me on Chatterbait and he wanted me to put a collar on. I'm like, oh no, never, never, never. You're not gonna, he's like, I want to drag you around. I'm like, no, you're in the wrong place, babe.
You can put the collar on. I do that to people.
Exactly. I will
Ew.
never. That's degrading.
And it, yeah, and if degrading yourself is your kink, I'm here to degrade you.
Exactly. See, I can't really get into it. I tried. Someone, I just feel bad. I don't know why, but like someone wanted me to do SPH, and I just was like, my lollipop is bigger than your dick. Like I didn't know what to say. Like I just felt horrible the whole time.
Small, can you SPH?
Penis humiliation. Small penis
I do
humiliation.
those a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just, it's not for me, but I mean, if you can do it, fucking do it. You know, do it good. I'm sure you do.
Yeah, small penis humiliation. Sorry, there's so many abbreviations that it's like hard to.
There
Yeah, I didn't know that I was a dom. It.
Isn't that crazy? You find it out when you're camming. You just found it out.
I'm like, oh shit, actually, this makes fucking perfect sense.
Yeah. Isn't it nuts? Because I found out like a lot about myself too, like what I'll do and like what I feel comfortable with. And if I hadn't have done camming, I wouldn't don't think I'd ever know, you know?
Like
So I mean, it is a good experience.
I don't do butt stuff.
No, it's not your forte.
I can't. And everyone wants to do butt stuff, and I'm like, I can't. Listen, it feels like my asshole is ripping. This is live. I could shit on live on accident. I could fart on live. No.
Yeah, there's a lot of shit that can go down. Literally.
I'm not prude. I'll show you the butthole.
You just don't like it. Yeah, I'll show you that shit. I'll bend over and show you, but you're not gonna put nothing in it,
Can you imagine the worst possible thing would happen? It's on
I
live,
know. Oh my God.
and then it's stolen on another site forever.
Yeah, making mad money off of your assholes out there forever.
Fucking short on a live stream.
Oh my God. Oh my God. That would be my luck too, because I have the worst luck and it would be everywhere. So your YouTube channel, when did you start that?
Like 3 years, four years ago.
I checked out a few videos. I like how you talk about the real shit. Like I always say, I keep it real. You keep it real too.
I try to keep it mild because I'm like, if I get real, like I'm unlikable sometimes.
Yeah. I'm always like over the top and talk about everything way too much and give out, you know, too much risque information. And people are like, people can't handle me. It's kind of funny.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's definitely the YouTube thing is definitely. How many followers do you have on there? Do you have a lot of people that watch you every time?
I don't have that many. I have about 3,000, and if I'm going to be
That's good
honest with
though.
myself, I haven't been super consistent with it. Like last, I uploaded like 2 days ago, but before that had been 2 months, and that's my own fault for not being disciplined and consistent with it.
It's hard to be disciplined, because when you're self-employed, like I'm like, I don't gotta work, but I should, you know? It's hard some days.
Well, you talked about mental health in the beginning of this video, and I struggle with, I guess, depression. I don't know. I've been diagnosed with so much shit. They can't figure me out.
Too. Me too. No medication works. Yeah.
My Zoloft,
You're on
but
Zoloft right now?
yeah, technically it's sertraline.
Yeah, that worked. I was on that for a little bit. It worked okay. I have depression, anxiety, PTSD. I'm agoraphobia. I have a slew of shit, man. Like the only thing that worked on me was lithium. I'm medication resistant. So yeah, they've tried. I felt like a lab rat. Like I've tried every fucking pill there is out there.
Yeah.
And now I'm unmedicated. I kind of.
I don't blame you for not being medicated.
It's hard, man. That shit, a lot of that shit made me feel like just I was on the couch. I couldn't even move like a zombie. Like, I don't want to be that way in life.
I was in the hospital from my Zoloft because they put me on
Really?
such a high dose that my body, my muscle spasms, I was having involuntary muscle spasms. I
Jesus.
had to go to the hospital, yeah. And I do like my Zoloft and I like happy pills, but also I do a lot of research on stuff with good old Google, and the long-term effects are not good. So I do plan on eventually getting off of it. It's a crutch.
Yeah, it is. It's to help you through a stage in life, you know, until I'm a whole herbal remedy type of girl. I'm all about tea, about herbs. And I like to do that instead.
Yeah.
I've actually been handling my issues with meditation. And that's been rough because I'm not very disciplined, but trying. But yeah, it's a struggle. And then when you get on here and people got to say stupid shit, it triggers something to me sometimes. I just get really angry or I just get really sad and I have to leave. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard.
Yeah.
It's really hard.
Yeah.
But I think, you know, that needs to be addressed more. Oh, speaking of mental health, do you know what I found out that is a resource, a huge resource for sex workers? Have you heard about pineapple therapy? Mm-hmm. Or pineapplesupport.org. That's what it is. I happen to hear about it. It's a organization that gives free services to all sex workers of all kinds. Therapy, support groups, videos, anything under the sun. I'm in two of the support groups currently.
Amazing.
But it's free. And it's supported by Chatterbait, My Free Cams, Cam4, a shit ton of them pay for it. So
no, I didn't
check it out.
Thank you so much.
The videos on there. Pineapplesupport.org. The videos are amazing. If you just have a question about something, it's there. I swear. It's there.
Awesome. Thank you so much for sharing that.
You're welcome. You're welcome. It really helps me because sometimes I just feel like, you know, I just don't feel okay. I need something.
It's okay not to feel okay.
I love that book. It's a great book.
It's a book?
It is. It's amazing. It has to do a lot with grief, processing grief and stuff like that.
Shit.
It's a great book. Check it out. It's okay if you're not okay. That's what it's called. Yeah, that's a good resource.
I feel like somebody told me that and I didn't know it was a book.
Yeah, I read it a couple years ago. It's pretty good.
Fuck.
But yeah, that pineapple, I actually did a therapy. I got free therapy. It's based upon your income. And it was, you know, over Zoom and it was really awesome. Really cool. Yeah.
I struggle with therapy.
Me too. I want to quit this one because I always want to quit everything I start.
Yeah.
I just feel like sometimes like a therapist, they should go through the shit that you went through while you're there, you know, while you're there for therapy. Because sometimes they don't even know, like, they don't know what's going on. How can they relate to me? It's what I always think. If you haven't experienced what I've been through, and how can you tell me what to do? That's my thing.
My last therapist started becoming like almost a girlfriend.
Oh.
To where she started venting to me and I was like,
ooh.
I'm not judging, but like,
yeah,
I could just talk to my girlfriends for this.
I know, right? So I'm saying you're supposed to be helping me. I've had like three therapists quit on me because I do a ton of research and I would always tell them what to tell me to do. And they're like, wow, like we really can't suggest anything else. I'm like, okay. Yeah, I'm a huge research person. I need to know everything. It's strange.
My last therapist did teach me about grounding. And I didn't know about that. So I did learn some stuff, but I don't know, maybe I should have stuck with her, but.
Yeah, it is what it is. You know, things always happen for a reason. That's what I look at it like. She wasn't meant for you, you know? Are you in therapy now?
No, I'm not. I just have a psychiatrist to give me my little happy pills.
Yep, you got to have one of those. But yeah, there's no shame. Anyone listening, there's no shame in that shit. If you need to take some pills to get you through something, you know, go for it. Just keep your mental health good.
Yeah.
It's very important.
It's super important. It's super important. And man, like, it's not just sex workers. Like, I feel like our nation is just like in general, like, there's like a depression, you know.
Yeah, the world is bad. The world is really bad right now, you know, the price of everything. And it's hard not to be depressed. Mm-hmm. You can't even freaking live right now, you know? It's bad.
Yeah.
So if you have a little pill to get you through and get you up in the morning, go for it. Do it.
So I watched the interview of you and Pete.
Mm-hmm.
How did this whole, I'm just curious. I know it's supposed to be like you asking me questions, but like, I just can't help it.
Oh, that's okay. How do I get to be a co-host?
Uh-huh.
Well, I just started talking to him and we found out we meshed together, you know, so we just kind of do this. It's fun as fuck.
Cool.
Yeah, I really like it. Because my whole thing in life is I'm a helper. I need to like inform people, you know, I like to give people tips, you know, I want to be that person. Mm-hmm. And his show goes, you know, in line with that. But yeah, we just kind of all just fell together. I like it a lot though. I love talking to you guys because I'm in the industry too. So it's good to like bounce shit off each other too. Make sure that we're, you know, we're not alone. Some days I feel alone, don't you? I don't have any cam girl community, do you?
No, not really.
That's the one thing I want to do is I want to set up like Zooms or something where we can all just get together and shoot the shit. That would be fun.
Yeah.
I'd be like, yo, you know, this dude came in here and made me do this shit. I want to do this shit. And, you know, we could just talk about ideas because sometimes I get bored and I don't know what to do on my show. And it'd be nice to talk to other people.
So you've been in it for twice as long as me or longer, obviously. How do you, like, have you thought about quitting, or when you get in your funks and stuff, like, how do you deal with that?
Yeah, I think about quitting every day, to be honest. Okay. I'm clearly honest. Mm-hmm. I don't really like doing it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't find a job. I'm overqualified because I know how to do a shit ton of stuff. And I've been trying to get a job for 2 years, like a real job. But if I got offered a job, I would walk away. Like, I would still help and advocate for sex workers, definitely. But yeah, I mean, it's really not my thing anymore.
If you could pick, like, what your real job would be, like, what would it be?
You're awesome, because that's one of my questions I had for you.
Okay.
If you weren't going to do this, what would your real job be? My real job? I would love to be an artist. I love to paint. I like to make things. Yeah, I'd be an artist. How about you?
I want to continue to be an entertainer, and I still want to be sexy, but I just don't want to be as an interactive like sex person. Yeah. Burlesque is
nice.
That I really want to do. I do want to dive into the whole dominatrix thing, and I want to stay on the social media platform for sure. Like,
yeah, that's awesome. Burlesque is beautiful too. I have a friend that runs a burlesque club, like a swinger burlesque club, and it's just amazing.
I don't see myself stopping taking my clothes off for money anytime soon, but right. It's very like camming is very, very like interactive, very personal. And I'm just like,
it is. It's draining. Like, seriously, when you get off, it's like, oh, some streams, I'm like, damn, I need a fucking drink after that. God, what the hell? Like, people talk to me a lot about their problems, which is fine, you know, to a point. And we take all that in. So when we get out, we're like, you know, we need a personal massage right after. We need a hot tub right after. We need something. I tell you.
I literally go do all that. I have, like, a little Asian massage girl.
I need to hire somebody. Like, oh, get over here and give me a massage. I had a rough day on cam.
I go to the local whorehouse and I'm like, come here.
Right? Yeah, that's awesome, though. At least you're doing self-care. Self-care is hugely important, especially for what we do, for your mind even. Like, you've got to get some self-care.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing to do for self-care?
Eat. Not healthy, but.
That's hard.
I love cooking and eating, and I love gardening.
Oh, that's awesome. I like gardening too. Most of my plants die, but it's fun.
Yeah.
It takes your mind out of life.
It's,
you know, it really does.
It's the best.
You really have to, like, I have ADHD, so like my brain's always like all the time. So it's when I garden too, like, it's nice to just look at the dirt and not think about anything else.
It's,
you know, your little seeds.
Yes.
Yep. You need that in your life. Everybody does.
Yeah.
So say if I was a cam girl, I was 18. I'm not a cam girl. Yeah. I'm a girl. I want to be a cam girl. I'm 18. What would you tell me if I'm like, hey, what's some shit I should know?
Your stuff is going to be on the internet forever. If you're going to get into this industry, please make the most out of it.
I love that.
Yeah.
It blows my mind that some people don't know that their shit's going to be online forever. I'm like, what? How can you not know that?
They don't.
You're out there forever.
Not just young people, just
anyone. I mean, that's just common sense to me. I guess I have a different mindset than a lot of people do. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's definitely a thing. I was on a Reddit post and someone said, like, oh my God, my shit got leaked and now it's online forever. I'm like, bitch, you were online forever when you first turned your cam on.
Yeah.
Like, people don't get it, but that's very important to stress that. I agree.
Yeah. I think that if you were super, super young and you were to come to me and be like, hey, I want a cam, like, what do you have to tell me? You can't take it back. It's going to be on there forever. And so if you're going to do it, please, for the sake of yourself and the community, do the best you possibly can for yourself. Because if you're just here to make a quick buck, you're going to make the money and you're going to spend it. And then your content is going to be out there forever.
Yeah.
So
I love that. That's very, very important. I love that. That's the greatest thing to say, I think. Bravo, my dear. Bravo. All right. Do you have anything to add to the podcast? Any little bits, pieces? We talked about a lot of shit tonight.
We did.
We covered a lot.
I have something to add.
What? What is it?
I wish you had your own channel so we can, like, get to know you.
Like, like in YouTube channel? Mm-hmm. Me?
Yeah.
I was thinking about it because I looked at yours tonight and I'm like, man, this is cool. Like I could do this, but then I'm just, I don't know. I should do something.
I think you should.
That'd be cool.
I think
I love meeting all you guys. Like you guys are all so different, but we're also alike in a way.
Yeah.
It's like, we need our own community. We really do.
Yeah. I think you should definitely do that. Like, let us get to like, know you.
Yeah. That would be fun. We could do something like that. That'd be really cool. But yeah. It's great getting to know you. I mean, you're great. You're amazing. I love what you do. You know, you got a good mindset, your head's in the game. You got this. Yeah. I mean, well, good luck with the YouTube channel. You're definitely going to be more disciplined and you're going to go crazy with that. You just talk like a real life person. And that's what I like to hear.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Welcome.
Thank you for taking your time.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Well, you have a good night. Go do some self-care. Okay.
Bye.
All right. See you later, girl. Bye.
Bye.
All right, guys. That was Daya Fallon. Totally awesome interview. I learned a lot. A lot of similarities between her and I. So yeah, go check it out. Never know what you're going to take away from one of our podcasts. There's a ton of information every time and different all the time. So that's Daya Fallon, and we'll put her links in the description on the show, and also support us on Patreon and all of our socials. All right, guys, have a great night.